to Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, to Berlin. Crowds have gathered, so George Floyd's last words don't die with his killing. A huge mural erected along the iconic path of the old Berlin Wall. In Montreal, the message the same. Prime Minister Justin Trudeau adding his own cautionary words. No country immune to this scourge.
Anti-black racism is real. It's in the United States, but it's also in Canada.
In Ireland, North and South, George Floyd, larger than in life, remembered on Dublin's walls. Transatlantic ties, making this killing feel closer to home. And in London, protesters came in their thousands, gathering amidst the grandeur of Trafalgar Square, marching off toward the US Embassy, pausing outside the Prime Minister's office to tell him what they think.
Everywhere in the world. People choose to think that it's not going on anymore. That's the biggest racism of all right now, the fact that they're sitting there thinking that it doesn't exist. This is proof that it exists.
In Paris, silence for remembrance, for a life taken so callously. America's friends are watching, and they are worried.
We want to see a de-escalation of all of those tensions in America come together.
More protests are planned for London, where 23 people were arrested Sunday, some for breaking lockdown rules, which bans groups larger than six. America's own challenge is rippling out. So far, more peaceful than the nightly storms filling US streets. All the same, a measure of how racism scars our common cause.